there probably will be no less than 200 different people who participated in some way to make this happen. And without any one of those, this couldn't have happened.
Reliable power service is one of those things you don't think much about. You simply flip on a switch and the lights go on. At Orcas Power and Light Cooperative, it's our job to think about it. We care about making sure our members have what they need to power their lives and livelihoods. From our board, to our staff, to our line crews who call the islands home, we care about serving our island community with safe, reliable, cost-effective, and environmentally sensitive utility services. We've enjoyed a long history of doing just that, serving Washington State's San Juan County since 1937. Now, we're taking measures to ensure that our efforts continue well into the future with the installation of a new modern submarine cable that connects to San Juan Island, the most heavily populated island in our 20-island service area.
This cable that we're installing, calling George, that we're going to run from Otis Perkins Park on Lopez Island across the channel through about 250 feet or 300 feet of water depth over to the Pear Point side over on San Juan. On the San Juan side, the character is a tight little cove that has private property all the way around with one little easement that Opalco has up to the middle of it, and then a very, very, very steep bank going up to where the substation is. On the Lopez side, we installed a conduit that goes all the way from the shore down underneath the intertidal zone, underneath the eelgrass, and then come out about 350 feet from the shore out into about 30 feet of water. And that 30 feet of water is about 50 feet waterward of the existing eelgrass.
The new cable will deliver reliable power service and enhanced communications capabilities for the next 50 plus years.
The investment that Opalco is making now will drive the economy of San Juan County for decades to come.
Let's take a sneak peek at how our unique system works. It all starts with the federal Columbia River power system, which generates most of our power. Dams along the Columbia and other nearby rivers generate hydroelectricity, which then moves across a transmission grid to Fidalgo Island. 11 transmission lines and 15 distribution submarine cables provide power to more than 11,000 customers across 20 islands.
We are one of the most complex utilities in the nation, and we are experts at serving our unique island communities. Our isolated service territory requires us to put safety and reliability as amongst our top priorities, always in balance with our stewardship of our sensitive and beautiful environment.
Opalco is preparing our grid to integrate more renewable sources and more locally distributed power. Yet, even as we embrace new technologies, our system will always include a submarine cable. Think of it like a big extension cord extending from the mainland to the islands. It provides the firming power for our intermittent renewables and a secure, reliable source of power 24/7, 365. Put into place in 1977, the existing cable was becoming old and frayed, and it was also the last crossing in our system that didn't include fiber optics, which is now essential. Our new 13,596-foot cable, which weighs in at a whopping 34 pounds per foot, increases power capacity and is easy to quickly repair with limited cost. The magic ingredient? Fiber.
Embedded in this cable is 144 strands of fiber that allow us to automate our system. It was the final link to connect all of our SCADA systems together.
This allows us to look at what's going on in real time and then allows us to react appropriately and get power on as quickly as we possibly can.
Upon inspection of the existing cable, we discovered something that could potentially cause outages. It turns out our existing cable was entangled with a telecommunications cable installed by CenturyLink.
The fiber optic cable and the power cable are critical to keeping this island up and going. So our real problem has been in How do we protect these two assets while we're working in close vicinity of them?
We couldn't run the risk of what happened in 2013 when the CenturyLink cable outage caused critical 911 services to temporarily become unavailable to island residents. With the new submarine cable, we have the capacity to carry essential emergency communication services, if need be, further ensuring the safety of the communities we serve. As you can expect, a project like this is costly. It comes with a $15 million price tag, to be specific. That's why we're dedicating efforts to ensure the project is completed as efficiently as possible.
The asset that's created gradually pays off the loan. It's a huge loan, but because it lasts for so long, it has a long time to pay itself off.
Think about it this way. This project will pay for itself twice over, based on the power it will yield in the first 20 years of service. And, thanks to the cable's high-efficiency, low-maintenance qualities, members can expect cleaner, more stable power, and greater system reliability, resulting in significant cost savings over the life of the cable.
Environmental stewardship is embedded into every project that Opalco does. From removing the oil-filled cables, to watching salmon migrations, to bird nesting, Opalco looks at all these factors when doing their projects.
Resiliency is the DNA of our cooperative. We want to look out after the community and make sure that we're there for you when you need us the most.